small points, but he's like kind of heavy.
I like that bowl. Oh yeah, that's good. Thank you.
Got him. Hey, rack another one. Oh. Oh, man. Dude. We got him.
All right, man. We just dropped a gorgeous 6-point elk.
Right.
We had a good shot on him this morning. And I was just right so there. Nerved up that I could not feel good about pulling the trigger. And we came out tonight. We saw this elk and watched him for the last 2 hours, 3 hours. Saw him way up high. We picked it up and he was following a couple of cows. He's been bugling. Watched him follow this cow down. We didn't think he was gonna come down here. They're heading for this watering hole right here. And
some little water.
He was down there. He's got a glimpse of us. He came up side hill in a little bit. Wes hit a cow call and he stopped and I drilled him. And this bull is gorgeous. I've been just at the highs and lows of this whole thing. This morning I was just kicking myself because I was nerved up. I was cold. I didn't want the hunt over. And so he came out tonight and I just all kind of relaxed because I didn't think he was going to come out of up here. And sure enough, he came down, moved towards this watering hole. Wes took us through the trees and kept us pretty much out of sight. And now we got it. We got a tag punched.
We're gonna find this bugger.
Hands on him.
It's a beautiful animal. It's kind of a sacred thing. Taking care of your own food. Beautiful animal. What an experience today. What an experience. That is a bull I am tickled to death with. Kind of bladed out on his sixth.
Look at these hooks. Beautiful hooks. Nice
and fourth and
good back end.
5-6, good back end.
You see all this just from when he was thrashing?
He was bugling. We watched him rake. I don't know how many different trees. I can't believe he came down here and we were able to get him. That is unbelievable.